Welcome to a lesson on the probability of independent events. Let's begin by reviewing basic probability. The probability of an event represents the likelihood it will occur. Probability compares the favorable number of outcomes to the total number of outcomes. So we say the probability of event E is equal to this quotient here, where the probability can be expressed as a fraction, decimal, or percentage. But in this lesson, we're concerned about independent events, where events A and B are independent if the probability of event B occurring is the same whether or not event A occurs. So here are two examples of independent events. Number one, a fair die is rolled 2 times. The outcome of the second roll is not affected by the outcome of the first roll. So we can say the probability of rolling a particular number the second time is the same whether or not the first roll occurs. Number two, picking a card from a deck and flipping a coin would also be 2 independent events because the outcome of one event does not affect the outcome of the other. And if 2 events are not independent, they would be dependent. And here's an example of 2 dependent events. Draw a card from a deck without replacement and then draw another card. Notice in this case, the probability of selecting a particular card the second time would be affected by the card that was drawn the first time, and that's because there's no replacement. If there was replacement, then we would have 2 independent events. And when 2 events are independent, the probability of both occurring is the product of the probabilities of the individual events. So again, if events A and B are independent, then the probability of A and B is equal to the probability of A times the probability of B. Let's take a look at some examples. You flip a fair coin and pick 1 card out of a hat containing 20 cards numbered from 1 to 20. What is the probability of getting heads on the coin and a number greater than 15 from the hat? So we want to know the probability of flipping the coin and getting a head and picking a number that's greater than 15 from the hat. So we'll say and n is greater than 15. Because these 2 events are independent, this probability is equal to the probability of flipping a head times the probability of selecting a number greater than 15 from the hat. The probability of getting a heads from the coin flip would be 1/2. There's 2 outcomes. One of which is favorable, times the probability of selecting a number greater than 15. There are a total of 20 numbers. There are 20 possible outcomes. To determine how many favorable outcomes there are, notice how there are 5 numbers greater than 15, 16 through 20. So this would be 5/20, which does simplify to 1/2 times common factor of 5. Here that'd be 1/4. Which is equal to 1/8. So we can say the probability of flipping a head and selecting a number greater than 15 is equal to 1/8 as a fraction. As a decimal, that would be 0.125, which we can get by taking 1 and dividing by 8. Converting to a percentage, we'd multiply by 100 and add a percent sign. So this is the same as 12.5%. Here's 3 different ways to represent this probability. Next, you roll a fair die twice. What is the probability of rolling a 3 on the first roll and an even number on the second roll? So we want to find the probability of rolling a 3 and an even on the second roll. Because these 2 events are independent, this is equal to the probability of rolling a 3 times the probability of rolling an even number. So the probability of rolling a 3 is only 1 favorable outcome out of 6, so that'd be 1/6, times the probability of rolling an even number. Well, 2, 4, and 6 are even, so there's 3 favorable outcomes out of a total of 6. Let's simplify 3/6 to 1/2. So 1/6 times 1/2 is equal to 1/12. So we can say the probability of rolling a 3 and on the second roll, rolling an even number is equal to 1/12 as a fraction, as a decimal. We have 0.083 repeating, which we'd write like this. Or if we went around, we may round to 3 decimal places, which would be approximately 0.083. As a percentage, the exact value would be 8.3 with a bar percent, or we might just say 8.3%. Let's take a look at one more example. A card is pulled from a deck of cards and noted. The card is then replaced, the deck is shuffled, and a second card is removed and noted. What is the probability that both cards are face cards? Well, there are a total of 52 cards pictured here, where 12 of them, jacks, queens, and kings, are the face cards, one of each suit, and there are 4 suits. So we want the probability of a face card with replacement, and then getting another face card the second time. So because there's replacement, these two events are independent. If there wasn't replacement, they would not be independent. But because we're independent, this is equal to the probability of a face card times the probability of another face card. Again, there are 12 face cards out of a total of 52 cards. So this would be 12 divided by 52 times 12 divided by 52. 12 and 52 do share a common factor of 4. So both of these fractions simplify to 3/13. So we have 3/13 times 3/13, which is equal to 9 divided by 169. Let's go ahead and express this again 3 ways. The probability of a face card and a face card is equal to, as a fraction, 9 over 169. As a decimal, we'd have 9 divided by 169. Let's go ahead and just round this to 4 decimal places. We'll say it's approximately 0.0533, or as a percent, would be approximately 5.33%. Okay, that's going to do it for this lesson. I hope you found this helpful.